Hi guys, welcome to my channel. So today I am in a bit of a different setting. I am on vacation in Colorado with my family. So for this look today, I did a warm kind of smoky eye to heat up this cold weather we're having here, but it's going to be a mix of oranges, browns, cranberries, kind of some earth tones for you. So if you want to see how I got this look, then please keep watching. To start off our eyes, I am using the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion in the color Eden. And I always start with a primer because this will help lock in our eyeshadow all day. It just sets the base like we use a primer for our foundation. I use this for my eyes. So I dab it all over and let it sit for a minute and let it get a little bit tacky, and then I blend it in all over my eye. And it will also help make the colors a lot more vibrant on our eyelids. Next, since I'm doing a dramatic eye, I am taking scotch tape and putting it on the back of my hand first to remove some of the stickiness. And then I am putting this on an angle underneath my lower lashes and up towards my eyebrow. That will help give us a nice crisp look. For the transition shade, I am using this burnt orange color from the Jolie Beauty palette. This is a palette from the UK and it is so gorgeous. So I'm working this burnt color into the transition area to help go from our light shades at the top to our dark crease shades. To deepen that a little, I am taking Cashmere Bunny from the Natural Eyes Too Faced palette, and you can use any lighter brown shade for this. I'm mixing between a couple palettes here, but I am working this a little bit below where we just put our transition shade. Next, I am taking this darker cranberry shade from the Jolie Beauty palette, and I am going to deepen up that crease and make it a little bit more dramatic. So working that onto the outer third of our eye, and then dragging excess product in towards the center in windshield wiper motions. I also like to be a little heavier in the outer corner and work this onto the tape, because when we remove it, we'll get that really crisp line. And then I am just going back over with a clean blending brush and just kind of working all of this together to help smooth it out and make sure we don't have any dark patchy areas. To clean this up a little bit more, I am taking the color Heaven from the Natural Eyes Too Faced palette, and I am just putting this bone white shade up by my eyebrow. And next I am going in with I Want It All. This is a micro glitter from the Too Faced Beauty Agenda palette, and I am popping this onto the center of my eye. Next, I'm going in with Halo from that same Boss Lady Beauty Agenda palette onto the inner corner of my eye. And again, I'm mixing palettes a lot, but you can use similar shades from whatever you have at home. Moving on to my eyebrows, first I am spooling them up so that all the hairs are standing in the direction I want them to go. And then I actually use the eyeshadow from the Too Faced Natural Eyes palette, the Sexpresso, on an angled brush, and I just kind of fill in my brows with that. For eyeliner, I am using the Maybelline Eye Studio Gel Pot in the color Blackest Black, and I am taking a sharp angled brush and just working this along the lower lash line. And I am also winging it out a little bit and using that tape as a guide. This again will help give us a nice crisp line when we remove that tape. For concealer, I am using Tarte's Shape Tape, and I believe this is in the color Light Neutral, but I'll have it in the description box down below. And I am using this to highlight all the high points of my face. So we're concealing under the eyes and then going on the chin, middle of my forehead, and down the bridge of my nose to get that nice highlighted look. And I know this is everyone's go-to concealer, but I do find it to be a little bit drying, so I like to apply an extra layer of moisturizer under my eyes before applying it so they don't get dried out. To set this, I am taking the Tarte Amazonian Clay Finishing Powder and my damp beauty blender, and I am just stamping on the powder under my eyes. And I know at the end, it actually ended up being, I didn't wipe enough of it away, so it was a little too white, and this does leave a flashback, so be warned. For blush, I am using the Tarte Blush Palette and going in with this nice mauvey berry color. And the blush came out a lot heavier than I was expecting, as you can see here, so I went back in with my powder brush and just tried to blend that out as best as I could. For all over powder, I'm using the Absolute powder from Lancome, and this is in the shade Absolute Pearl. And I am just applying this all over my face with a big fluffy powder brush. For bronzer, I am using the Glamour Dolls collaboration with Lisa Frank. This came in one of my Ipsy bags. And I am applying this underneath my cheekbones, kind of in the hollows, to bring some dimension and color back to my face, and then just along the top of my forehead. To sharpen up that contour line a little bit, I am using some of the Tarte Amazonian finishing powder and my beauty blender, and just applying this underneath my cheek. So if you like the more blended out look, you don't have to do this step, but this just helps kind of create a more dramatic line along your face. If you are following along with these steps, we should all be looking like Neapolitan ice cream right about now. I am doing a little nose contour with just a dark eyeshadow down the sides of my nose and blending that in. Next, I am wiping away the bake, and again, like I said earlier, I didn't get enough of this wiped away under my eyes, so it does look a little too brightened, so do a better job than I did blending this out. For highlight, I am using the AOA Studio highlighter in the color Cream Puff, and I am just applying this to the tops of my cheekbones, the tip of my nose, and then a little bit to my Cupid's bow. Going back to under the eyes, I'm taking that burnt orange shade and just buffing this under my lower lash line and deepening the color with that dark cranberry on a definer brush and working this tighter along the lower lash line. To darken the color, I am taking Sexpresso from the Too Faced Naturalize palette and still using that tiny definer brush. I am working this against the lower lash line and focusing heavily on the outer corner and then lightly buffing it towards the center. For mascara, I am using the Lancome Definisils, and I am just applying this to my upper and lower eyelashes. Don't you wish putting on mascara always went this fast? To finish off the look, I am using Too Faced Melted Matte Liquid Lipstick, and this is in the color Sellout. I really love this color. It's like a nice nude but has some mauvey pink undertones to it. It's also really comfortable on the lips and very long lasting.
All right, guys, this is the finished look for today. It's a little less dramatic since I didn't do eyelashes today, but it's still a perfect either fall look or kind of everyday. It has a lot of the natural tones in it, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye, guys.